Welcome to the Disney Channel, the perfect family place for fantasy and fun, for imagination and adventure. And we even have a few surprises up our sleeves. It's all Disney's best, from the Disney Channel to you. And in this volume, here's what you'll see.
As they say, it's just the beginning. In the months ahead, you'll see more great movies for the whole family, more new shows that are fun to watch, easy on the eyes, and packed with the things that you want to know. The people at the Disney Channel want you to know that that's a promise, a commitment to bringing you and your family the kind of quality television you'll be glad to welcome into your home.
All personnel, 1 minute to Disney Channel programming. Donnie, will you start the audible countdown, please?
Well, you want me to start the countdown? Geez, this is an honor. Okay, we all set? All systems ready to go? Okay, you ready to roll programs in there? Great, okay, here we go. Mickey Mouse, Earth Station Mickey, stand by to commence countdown.
Mouse Control, this is Earth Station Mickey. You are cleared to commence countdown, Donnie.
Here we go. Ready? 30.
29.
28.
27.
23. The Disney Channel is on the air. Good morning. This is the Disney Channel. We invite you to share the magic of this day, dedicated to the finest in family entertainment. Welcome to your family place.
Disneyland.
boys and girls, we hope you have a pleasant stay here at the happiest place on earth, Disneyland.
We're going to have so much fun in Minneapolis, skiing and fishing and, man.
Maybe it wouldn't be so hard to move if I could take my friends with me.
Yeah, I know what you mean, Heather. But it'll be okay. You'll see. Look, I got to meet Cindy at the Haunted Mansion. I'll see you here in an hour. Right here, okay? All right? Hey, Heather. Are you all right?
I'm just fine. I'm 7, remember? Billy, where's my Mickey Mouse?
Here you go, Miss Maturity. Bye-bye.
See you later.
Okay. Hey, Heather. Come here. Here's a penny.
Uh-huh.
Why don't you go over to the wishing well and make a wish? Might work.
Okay.
Hey, Heather. Heather. Here's another one for me. You never know. Bye-bye.
Bye. It's worth a try, isn't it, Mickey? Let's do it, Mickey.
And you can. From Walt Disney's new Fantasyland in Disneyland. Starring Maury Amsterdam and Heather O'Rourke. Featuring Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Donald Duck, Snow White, the Seven Dwarfs, Pinocchio, Captain Hook, Stromboli, Alice, the Queen of Hearts, Wendell Shaker and Liverlips, the Wicked Witch, and also featuring Lance Sloan as Billy, and Marianne Seltzer as Mom. Believe You Can and You Can will return in a moment.
It's the Del Monte Parade of Savings from Disneyland. Receive up to $5 in savings by mail when you collect labels from the Del Monte family of products. Win up to $5,000 in the Match and Win sweepstakes. Details and money-saving coupons are in your Sunday paper, April 24th, and at participating grocers. Plus special savings on Del Monte products. So believe you can, and you can win $5,000 in the Del Monte Parade of Savings.
Mr. Chiffy.
Why? To make it more exciting, more wonderful, more magical than ever before. Let me show you. Is this something? Look at these pictures. You and your friends will have longer rides with Peter Pan. Down here, Snow White's scary adventure. Mr. Toad's wild ride. And look at this, the new Dumbo ride. Wow, it'll blow your mind.
That's super. When can I see it?
Right now. Oh, but first I gotta say the magic words. Yagazoozie, 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 zim. Zimmy, dimmy, zimmy, dimmy, wim, wim, wim.
Nothing happened.
Don't worry, it will. Just follow me. Welcome to my sanctum sanctorum.
Your what?
Oh, it's my office. Wonderful. You can see everything that's going on in Fantasyland. Look over there. That's where Snow White's scary adventure is going to be. We finish real soon now.
What are they doing?
Well, they're putting the finishing touches on the new Fantasyland. I'm going to show you what the new Fantasyland in Disneyland is going to look like. Yep, I guess it's just like Walt Disney always said. Disneyland will never be completed. It's just going to grow and grow and grow as long as there is imagination left in the world. Now, this is the actual scale model of what will become the new home for all your Disneyland friends. Going to be truly a new Fantasyland. Now, that's where Dumbo's new home is going to be. You know, he's getting ready to move already. He's got his trunk packed and everything. And this is where Peter Pan is going to fly in every night. This is Toad Hall. Don't those big doors just make you want to hop in? This is where Pinocchio lives. There's a big door so he can get his nose through it. And here is Snow White's house. Now, in the new Fantasyland, in Pinocchio's daring journey, you'll actually see the exact time and the spot when the blue fairy turned Pinocchio into a real boy, just like you saw in the film.
I can really see that? Pinocchio's daring journey? Why, Pinocchio never had his own adventure in Fantasyland before. I wish I could go inside and see for myself.
Well, you wish it, you got it. Yakazoozie, yakazoozie, zim, zam, zim. Wimmy, dimmy, wimmy, dimmy, wim, wham, wim. Look, with my Fantasyland magic, we're right in the middle of the artist's sketch of Pinocchio's daring journey.
Chippy, this is exciting. It looks so beautiful.
Yeah, we're walking into the future. We're going to go right from the sketch into the actual scale model of Pinocchio's daring ride. Well, here we are.
Wow! Can we go in?
Sure. Got to try a little magic first. Open sesame.
Chiffy.
Okay, come on, let's go in. Ready?
Yep.
Hold on tight, here we go.
Chiffy, look! It's just like in the film.
I got no strings to hold me down, to make me fret or make me frown.
And now, 1983, Disneyland Ambassador to the World, Mindy Wilson.
Good morning. Welcome to the grand opening and rededication of Fantasyland. Fantasyland has always been a magical place, a place where we can relive our favorite fairy tales, and if we believe, our dreams will come true.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the President and Chief Executive Officer for Walt Disney Productions, Ron Miller, and his wife, Diane Disney Miller, and Mrs. Walt Disney Million.
Thank you, Mindy, and welcome to all of you on behalf of the Disney organization. Walt Disney created a special place where parents and children could share pleasant times together, exploring adventure and fantasy, and experiencing both yesterday and tomorrow. Since Disneyland opened in 1955, almost 225 million people have walked through our gates down Main Street. Walt Disney's words on the day we open are just as appropriate today as we unveil a new fantasy land for a new generation of guests from around the world. I'm especially pleased that the lady who stood by his side for all those years is here today to share this occasion. We have here a plaque that has the words inscribed on it that Walt spoke some 28 years ago. And if I may, at this time,
here's the world of imagination, hopes, and dreams. In this timeless land of enchantment, the age of chivalry, music, magic, and make-believe art are reborn. Here fairy tales come true. Fantasyland is dedicated to the young and the young in heart, to those who believe that when you wish upon a star, your dreams really do come true. Thank you.
Maleficent?
Oh, I shall leave. But I will return. I'll get you, Prince Philip, and your sleeping beauty.
Open the Fantasyland Castle in the name of the children of the world.
Ago, Walt Disney staked his reputation and his pocketbook on what he called an amusement park for the young and young at heart. Today, a $42 million renovation of one of the park's favorite attractions, Fantasyland, was unveiled. Our Orange County correspondent Dave Lopez has a live report from the Magic Kingdom. David?
Connie, no matter how many times you've been to Disneyland in the past, when you come into the new Fantasyland, you get the feeling that you have never been in this park before.
What they wanted to create, they have done it in a very spectacular fashion.
Orange County reporter Bonnie Haynes is out there at Disneyland. Nice assignment, huh? She's got a live update. What's going on out there, Bonnie?
Oh, Kelly, it's beautiful. We're inside Fantasyland, completed just days ago. And yet, as you look around this Tyrolean village, it's been carefully aged to look hundreds of years old. And that's all part of the magic of Disneyland, first opened 3 decades ago.
Open the Fantasyland Castle in the name of the children of the world.
Thank heaven for Disneyland, you know.
Do they know how to put on a show?
Now, the milestone in the continuing development of Disneyland today, the all-new Fantasyland. Reporter Barney Morris was there for this morning's second grand opening and says it was no less grand than the first.
As spectacular as all this is, believe it or not, it's not finished yet. A whole new Alice in Wonderland attraction is expected to be put in here by summer of 1984. This is Barney Morris reporting for Channel 7 Eyewitness News at Disneyland.
Reporting in Anaheim, I'm Berta Piazza, Channel 30 Action News.
Of course, the designers of the new Fantasyland couldn't leave out my childhood favorite, and perhaps yours too, Dumbo, the Flying Elephant. This ride has a new home and a whole new look.
In this new Disney attraction, Pinocchio's daring journey traces the paths of right and wrong that Pinocchio follows in his adventure.
Sebastián, usted trabajó en los últimos cambios que hicieron aquí en la Tierra de Fantasía. ¿Por qué los cambios?
Bueno, los cambios se van de acuerdo porque Walt Disney desde un principio...
Efectivamente, Sonia, y pronto esperamos que podremos regresar a este gran mundo de Disney y especialmente ahora con este nuevo mundo de la fantasía que ha sido simplemente... un fenómeno para este gran parque de atracciones en el sur de California.
Hello, John. Oh, I wish you were here and Susie, too, and everybody watching. It's a wonderful night at Disneyland, and we're having a great time. What a place this is. We're in Fantasyland right now, the redone Fantasyland.
And right now, I'm coming to you live from Disneyland, the most popular attraction in California. Today, the all-new Fantasyland was opened in an elaborate ceremony. The Sleeping Beauty Castle Bridge was lowered for the first time since the park was opened in 1955. Also on hand were some of the people who had a hand in building the original Fantasyland.
Fantasyland has just been renovated, but it just wouldn't be Fantasyland if they hadn't kept the old carousel. Now, that carousel is the oldest one in America, and Walt Disney brought it to Disneyland back in 1955. We're going to take a ride on it a little bit later.
The biggest difference you'll notice in Fantasyland is what they call the village. You see it around us here. The designers of the village wanted to make it look 400 years old. Imagine the difficulty of creating something brand new that was designed to look that old.
Gosh. Kevin, I saw you struggling.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you mind if I try it?
No, go ahead. No. Okay. Hey, I know I can't do it. You can't do it.
Now, let me concentrate.
Concentrate.
1, 2, 3.
Wait a minute, Carlo. What is this?
Now I know why they call this the happiest place on earth. I've been happy here all day.
Oh, so have I, Joe. And, you know, if you'd like to join Joe and me and the over 200 million people who visited Disneyland, well, we're going to tell you how.
Disneyland is just outside of Los Angeles in Anaheim, and now it's open year-round with a new admission policy for one price, which is $12 for adults. You get to ride all the rides you want to as many times as you want to all day. Plus... the free entertainment.
The Mouseketeers were standing with Mr. Disney, Uncle Walt, as we used to call him, in his apartment up above the fire station. And there was this big, huge, handsome man who was bringing happiness to everyone on Earth. And he was standing there with tears rolling down his face. And I feel like that now. I mean, this is just, it's just so true. And everything that they say about Disneyland, that it's the happiest place on Earth, it's so true.
There's a magical place not far from here where all your dreams come true. Where puppets turn into real boys and go on real adventures. Why, you can even learn to fly. And if you're lucky, you'll be king of the realm. Why, just anything can happen, like the biggest, bounciest parade you've ever seen. Come on, I'll show you.
See the new Fantasyland at Disneyland and the Flights of Fantasy parade every day.
I'll
Disneyland? We're gonna have so much fun.
Great for kids, but what about them?
Well, they'll love Donald's new parade. And the rides at Disneyland are just great. They'll go crazy for the new 3D film. And the stage show is tons of fun.
You kids are right. This is really fun.
Yeah. Dad, Disneyland's open tomorrow, you know. Disneyland days are fun for everyone.
There's a crazy celebration this summer at Disneyland. It's Donald Duck's 50th birthday. And what's new? Fantasyland and the new Alice in Wonderland attraction. Plus an incredible 3D nighttime experience. Disneyland is filled with adventure everywhere you look. Like American Journeys, this spectacular new Circle Vision attraction. And nighttime magic you won't find anywhere else. It's much too good to keep secret. Get quacking on summer's best vacation, Disneyland.
Donald says he's glad he's come to Disneyland to celebrate his birthday with the new parade. The new Alice in Wonderland adventure is just part of the fun. After dark, Disneyland is going to show a 3D film called Magic Journeys. And Disneyland rides are a real blast. There's lots of adventure in a Disneyland day. Timmy, come back!
Everything has been prepared, and now it's time for you to open the garden to the public. And it's so lovely, isn't it?
It's lovely. Mm-hmm.
Little bread and butterflies kiss the tulips, and the sun is like a toy balloon. There I get up in the morning glories, in the golden afternoon. There are dizzy daffodils on the hillside, strings of violets are all in tune. Tiger lilies love the dandelion.
and gentlemen, the Queen's garden is ready to be viewed. But first we must have a speech, don't you think? I mean, it's only proper, right? Well, I would like to introduce all of you to... Yes, oh, I'm sorry. I mean, Our Majesty would like to introduce Ellen Coleman, our Disneyland ambassador to the world, and Mickey Mouse.
Walt Disney once said that Disneyland is like Alice stepping through the looking glass. When you enter the portals of Disneyland, it's like entering another world. Ladies and gentlemen, Alice's world awaits us.
Thank you. And now, Your Majesty, the time has come to open your garden to the world. Here we go.
Don't miss the world premiere of American Journeys at Disneyland, an experience in pride filmed in Circle Vision 360.
Since 1960, more than 70 million people visiting Disneyland have thrilled to America the Beautiful, one of the first motion pictures ever to utilize Circle Vision, 9 screens completely surrounding the audience.
But since that film was made, the country has changed, as has film technology. So the Disney folks felt it was time for a completely new Circle Vision motion picture called American Journeys.
Sponsored by Pacific Southwest Airlines, the new film debuted in Tomorrowland and is the story of the American people told visually, their heritage, struggles, and sacrifices.
Thank you. Come walking in Disneyland's Christmas Wonderland and discover that warm holiday feeling in the magic of Christmas stage show. Then it's time for celebrating down home style at the brand new Country Bear Christmas Special. It's a swingin' sing-along good time. And share the holiday magic of the new Fantasy on Parade with your family. Explore the beautiful world of a Disneyland Christmas. It's the very best Christmas gift of all.
Christmas is a special time of year at Disneyland. A splendidly decorated Main Street, strolling Dickens carolers, and the colorful Fantasy on Parade are as much a part of holiday tradition here as St. Nick and eggnog are worldwide.
We're making tracks in.
This year, there's a new addition to the holiday lineup at Disneyland. It's called the Country Bear Christmas Special. And if these characters look familiar, it's because they're the same ones who star in the park's popular Country Bear Jamboree.
The Wonderland of Snow.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue just thinking about you.
Hey, help me out here.
You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white.
I can't hear you.
But have a blue Christmas.
Everybody knows I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
This is the first time that Disneyland has reprogrammed an existing attraction. Show designer Dave Fighton explains how it came about.
What we're looking for is something for Christmas time, a new exciting show that people could take their families to and enjoy at that special Christmas occasion. This new computer and new console was developed for the Epcot project, and with it we're able to reprogram the figures much quicker and faster with better movements, better artistic quality in them. And also because of it, there's a time factor that we save. Rather than months, it takes only a few weeks to make a whole new show.
I got my bag of presents, and I'm in your neighborhood. I'll be dropping down your chimney, cause I know you've been extra good. I'm your rock and roll Santa, baby. Your rock and roll Santa, baby, that's me. Oh.
The result is a Christmas celebration that Disneyland visitors should find entirely bearable. The show begins the day after Thanksgiving and runs through January 6th. Reporting from Disneyland, this is Joe Aguirre.
My heart and my truck and my dome.
You're invited to a birthday. The party's on us. The presents all yours. Disneyland's turning 30, and that's the magic number, because every 30th guest receives a gift. Tickets, Disney characters, commemorative watches, and 400 GM cars, about a car a day, all part of the 400,000 gifts given away during our year-long celebration. So join the party. Take your vacation at Disneyland, where the best has just begun.
It's called the Incredible Gift Giver Extraordinaire, and it's the centerpiece of Disneyland's 30th birthday party.
Every 30th guest, every 300th guest, 3,000, 30,000, 300,000, and 3 million are going to win prizes, and they're really super presents. Everywhere from Disneyland passports to we'll be giving away about 400 General Motors cars, 1985 Chevys, Pontiacs, Buicks, Oldsmobiles, and Cadillacs during our birthday year.
The Gift Giver is only the opening act in a celebration that will run all year long, according to the head of Disneyland Entertainment, Dennis Despy.
We start off with an opening a celebration, which includes a new parade, new shows, and a new general party atmosphere here at the park. Then come the May and June and July, we go into nighttime at Disneyland, followed by an International Festival Month, a salute to the original Mouseketeers, and followed up by what I think is the best time of all, Christmas time at Disneyland.
Art director Claire Graham has designed Disneyland's birthday atmosphere, including the 30th anniversary parade.
Mickey and Minnie would be on the front of the unit, singing and dancing. In the street around it, there have been a series of choreographed dancers planned in wardrobe. The music that goes along with the parade is very important. The focus of it is thank you, Mickey, thank you, Donald, Goofy, and all the rest for 30 wonderful years. Happy birthday, Disneyland.
Thousands of performers entertaining at Disneyland throughout the year get their direction from Barnett Ritchie.
In the summer, we're going to have a special show that salutes Disneyland since it's the 30th year. It's called Disneyland is Your Land, and it's a singing, dancing, musical variety show that incorporates all the characters into it, and it takes you on a musical journey through all the lands.
Disneyland's 30th birthday celebration began on January 1st.
Since you're our first 30,000th guest this year, you've just won a new 1985 Pontiac Sunbird. Congratulations!
The 30,000th guest, Julie Powell of Joplin, Missouri, won a new car. If there's one secret to Disneyland's longevity, it's that the cast and crew enjoy the show as much as the guests. And that will be especially true in 1985.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be a party for our total cast and everybody that's been that works here at Disneyland. All the hosts and hostesses, our management, everybody's excited about it. We want to have as much fun as our guests are going to have.
Right now at Disneyland, dreams are coming true.
No way! I want a car.
What a car!
During our 30th anniversary celebration, we're giving away 400 new General Motors cars. That's a car almost every day.
This is probably the best thing that's ever happened to me in my life.
Is this really mine?
Inside Disneyland, we're celebrating with the best ever parades and lively stage shows. So come catch Spring Fever at the biggest party ever at Disneyland.
And now we proudly present the Disneyland Family Cavalcade, starring the Maintenance Division, the clerical staff, foods, merchandising, custodial, attractions, finance, marketing, security, wardrobe, employee relations, and the entertainment division. Happy birthday, Disneyland. The best has just begun.
Do you remember when our popcorn was just a dime? You never had to stand in line. Down square speeches, hey, Mr. Disney. Can I meet Mickey Mouse? Tell you stories about the old days. Do you remember all the futuristic things we tried?
Famous flying saucer rides.
Mermaids, silver spacemen, catch a rocket to the moon. Do you remember?
On this very important occasion, we thought you might enjoy some mementos of your historic visit to Disneyland. So to begin, please join me in welcoming the President and Chief Operating Officer of Walt Disney Productions, Frank Wells, and his wife, Lou Ann.
I have the pleasure of giving you a lifetime pass to Disneyland, the Magic Kingdom and Epcot Center in Florida, for you and any three guests. That's four people, Brooks, for your entire life to Disneyland, this silver pass.
A studio accountant today recalled, and I quote, "A lot of people thought Walt Disney made his first major error 30 years ago. The accountant went on to say, amusement parks were considered bad places then, and here he was putting $17 million into an orange grove in California. The financial community thought he was crazy. Goofy, maybe. Crazy, no." 30 years later, Jerry Bowen looks at the world's most successful Mickey Mouse operation as Disneyland celebrates its birthday.
Party time at the Magic Kingdom with Mickey Mouse leading the singing. It's taken very much for granted now, but more than 30 years ago, when Disneyland was just so much empty space among the orange groves, still just Walt Disney's vision, most people thought the idea was preposterous.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land.
And opening day 30 years ago was nearly a disaster. Three times the expected crowd turned out, rides broke down, there was a gas leak in Fantasyland. Even the live telecast went goofy.
Signifying man's achievements. I thought I got a signal.
Yes. Ronnie Reagan, come on in. Yeah, how about that son of yours?
But with the help of some of his Hollywood pals, Disney's show came off, and Mickey and Minnie, who looked more like mice back then, introduced a bunch of kids who were soon to turn the yuppie generation onto television.
Here we are, these 24 unknown little kids with little black ears on our head, and nobody knew who we were because the show wasn't on yet. And it was kind of sweet to think that a year later, all these people came back and bought these little black ears for their kids.
Over the years, 250 million people have visited the park. 80,000 more are expected at today's 24-hour-long party. And Disneyland has become synonymous with squeaky clean, family fun.
I just love Disneyland. I'll be here till I die.
But the land of make-believe has not escaped real-world problems. A strike by employees last summer, the loss of a lawsuit brought by two gay men stopped from dancing together in 1980, declining attendance for the last 4 years. So change is coming. A high-tech dance hall to lure teenagers, for example.
I think the gamble is not fiddling with things, being complacent, saying it's all great. Pretty soon you find your audience is grown up and moved on to other things, and now you're just a nostalgia museum.
And so today, with a public relations fanfare that left little to chance, Disneyland turned 30, hoping to convince anyone who will listen there's still a lot of magic left in the Magic Kingdom. Jerry Bowen, CBS News, Anaheim.
And that's the CBS Evening News for this Wednesday. Dan Rather reporting from New York. Thank you for joining us. Good night.
Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Tinkerbell, Captain Hook, the Seven Dwarfs, Rob Weller, and Lisa Gibbons helped Disneyland celebrate birthday number 30 this week.
Walt Disney had a lifelong love affair with trains, so it came as no surprise to anyone, really, when one of the first attractions to be completed at the park was this 5/8 scale replica of a 19th century railroad.
Disney Studio craftsmen manufactured each detail from a blueprint of a real working steam engine. Then the finished product was trucked from Burbank to the site here in Anaheim. And 30 years ago, Walt climbed behind the throttle and opened up his dream to the public.
Hello, Walt. Hello, Governor. Hi.
Boy.
How'd the run go?
Oh, fine, fine. The governor had her around through Frontierland, and then Fred Gurley there, he took her around. I picked her up and brought her in. Highballing in, boy.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land.
But the grand opening that day was far from being a happy event. Rides broke down. Fantasyland was closed because of a gas leak, and there weren't enough toilets because of a plumber's strike. For the rest of his life, Walt Disney referred to opening day as Black Sunday. But Disneyland recovered and has done more than survive. It set the standard for amusement parks and has now been visited by almost a quarter of a billion people.
Disneyland's 30th anniversary celebration began at the stroke of midnight with every 3,000th visitor, including this four-year-old girl from Albuquerque, New Mexico, was given the keys to a brand new car. By daybreak, the park was filled with tens of thousands of people. News crews came from as far away as England and Japan. The crowd had come to help commemorate that magic moment 30 years ago when Walt Disney and an actor by the name of Ronald Reagan formally opened the doors to the Magic Kingdom.
Walt Disney has created a frontier village that could have been carved out of the wilderness 100 years ago.
Those who helped Walt design this park were among those on hand to celebrate. They say he would be proud of this day.
He never would take time to tell you how proud he was, but he would always be thinking of what's going to be the next step.
There were bands and floats, and all the Disney characters featured in this 30th anniversary celebration. The star of the show, the mayor of Disneyland, Mickey Mouse. There were representatives from Disney World and Disney Tokyo. The celebration built to a crescendo as cannons filled with confetti exploded. Thousands of balloons were released as skywriters flew overhead, writing out a happy 30th birthday. The show was an extravaganza. Former Mouseketeer Darlene Gillespie and her feelings about this special moment.
It doesn't seem like 30 years. I don't know, there must be something about being part of the Mickey Mouse Club. You honest to God feel like you never change as far as things just stay the same. And Bobby and I were saying that this morning. I mean, we can't believe it's 30 years.
It looks like the first 30 years of Disneyland have been very successful. And as many would say, far beyond the dreams and expectations of Disney himself. And the future promises more. Beginning in September, construction will start on a new attraction in Tomorrowland, featuring the combined efforts of filmmaker George Lucas and Disney. A happy anniversary to Disneyland.
Feverishly filled balloons with helium. And when I say balloons, I mean balloons. 1 million of them. Count them. It was all part of Skyfest, a celebration dreamed up by the city of Anaheim to honor the late Walt Disney on this, the 84th anniversary of his birth, and to say thanks to 30 years of successful operation of Disneyland. The balloons were placed in plastic tubes and taken to Catella Avenue outside the Disneyland Park, where they were released. Anaheim city officials were motored in, accompanied by some of the famous Disney characters. With a countdown, the balloons were set free. And what a sight it was. For those of you statistically minded, it took 451,000 cubic feet of helium to inflate the balloons, and all 1 million balloons could lift 190 people. But who cares about statistics? With a sight like this. As they drifted away, the multicolored balloons looked like jelly beans or sparkles on a cake. As those balloons floated off in the distance, the one question remains. Who cleans up 1 million deflated balloons? Joe McMahon, Channel 7 Eyewitness News in Anaheim.
Something to celebrate today. Something of the 30th anniversary of Disneyland, and that is not something to celebrate. What is? It is easy to see that the people of Anaheim know when and how to have a good time. 100,000 of them line the streets to see the balloon launch. A million balloons is quite a sight. Anaheim businesses put the Skyfest together as a way to say thank you for Disneyland and thank you to Walt Disney, who carved that whole Magic Kingdom out of orange groves about 30 years ago. Not coincidence, of course, that Skyfest also takes place on the day that Walt...
We can be a little more specific, 1,250,000 balloons, and that's...
Balloons will let go over the Magic Kingdom. That's a world record, by the way. In fact, our own Kevin O'Connell was the official MC for the celebration today. It's all to celebrate what would have been Walt Disney's 84th birthday and, of course, the 30th anniversary of Disneyland. All of the balloons cost $500,000. And as they get caught up in the jet stream, probably all the way to the East Coast and beyond, most of them probably will come down.
You're invited to the most memorable night in 30 years at Disneyland with superstar guest Alabama, the Pointer Sisters, Julian Lennon, Roy Clark, David Hasselhoff, and a loving look back at the great Disney friends we grew up with. It's a two-hour laugh-filled extravaganza, Disneyland's 30th anniversary celebration, Monday.
David Hasselhoff, Julian Lennon, Marie Osmond, the Pointer Sisters, Donna Summer, and Disneyland memories and surprises. So join Mickey and his friends at the Magic Kingdom for an evening of music, dance, fun, and fireworks. Now get ready, because Disneyland's 30th anniversary celebration is about to happen.
Oh, tonight's the night we're gonna make it happen.
Tonight we're gonna sing a party song, yeah.
Tonight's the night to join our celebration.
Tonight we're going to party all night long.
My heart is racing.
Racing. That's the first inside me. Anticipate and
wait. We just can't wait no more.
Come on, it's just getting late. Let's celebrate. I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it.
I know.
I want you.
Boy, I'm not the only one around Disneyland who's excited tonight.
Yes, I'm sure about that. But Drew, are you sure we're in the right Disneyland? I mean, where's everybody else?
It's my fault we're early. I didn't want to miss anything.
Oh, well, I can understand that. Sure, this is their 30th anniversary. It's a big night.
Yeah, you're telling me. When I heard about this party, I said, I gotta be there and bring you.
It isn't every man who gets to go out with a beautiful young lady named Drew Barrymore, you know.
It isn't every kid who gets to go out with someone who can drive.
Thank you.
Disneyland's 30th anniversary celebration with your host, John Forsythe, and co-host Drew Barrymore, with guest stars Alabama, Debbie Allen, Peter Allen, Julie Andrews, Bobby Barasini's orangutans, Roy Clark, David Hasselhoff, Julian Lennon, Marie Osmond, the Pointer Sisters, Donna Summer, special appearances by Harry Anderson, Mindy Cohn, the Cosby Kids, Kim Fields, Annette Funicello, John Machida, and Tina Yoders. Also starring Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Donald Duck, Goofy, and all their friends. Disneyland's 30th anniversary celebration is sponsored in part by McDonald's. It's a good time for the great taste of McDonald's.
All right, David, I got you here in Tomorrowland on time. Now, knock 'em dead.
To let you know, I can really shake them down.
Do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Now, do you love me? Now that I can dance. Watch me now. Well, I'll baby. Just a little bit of soul now.
your heart makes when you're fast asleep. In dreams you will lose your heartaches. Whatever you wish for, you keep. Have faith in your dreams, and someday your rainbow will come smiling through.
Yeah. stand up to give the whole world a go.
Birthday, you're not getting older, but you're getting better.
Disneyland, you're gonna live forever.
Have a good one, you're the best.
Happy birthday, Disneyland. I would have brought a gift for you, but what do you get to the park that has everything?
Happy 30th. You don't look a day over 29.
Happy birthday, Missy.